sit here and watch it.
So we think that if you're, well, you're gonna wanna write some things down. Okay, so guys, chemical equilibrium, we've only talked about reactions that have gone reactants, and then the arrow, they form products. Okay, but chemical equilibrium means that the forward and the reverse reaction occur at the same rate. So what does that mean? That means that the reactants are turning into products, but the products are turning back into the reactants, and it's all happening at the same time. So if you were to look at the reaction, it would look like nothing was happening. Okay, I have another video that I didn't show you today, and it shows a guy digging a hole, but then somebody else is filling the hole at the same rate. And so eventually it looks like that hole is just staying the same size because things are getting dug out at the same rate that they're getting filled back in. Definitely.
Wouldn't it eventually stop? Like, wouldn't it have?
Technically not.
No.
Well, this is assuming that you have a closed system. Okay, assuming you have a closed system and the matter can't be exchanged at all, then technically no, it would never stop. So, all right. So an example of this, guys, is nitrogen gas plus three hydrogen gases is in equilibrium. And it makes two NH3 gas plus heat energy. Okay, that is a reaction that can occur at equilibrium. And so what happens is the N2 and the H2 combine to form the NH3, but then the NH3 breaks apart into the N2 and the H2, and it all happens at the same rate. Notice, you guys, that the forward arrow and the reverse arrow, they kind of look like a what?
Equal sign.
An equal sign, yep. And so we can compare this reaction at equilibrium. You guys, I like to compare it to a scale. Daphne.
So would you be able to, like, make something, like, that heats up and just stays heated? Like, would that be possible with it? Or?
That's a good question. Now, there are some reactions that won't go in equilibrium, and so I'm not sure if that's possible.
Wait, isn't that impossible? Because the whatever you would be heating up would heat up the bowl or whatever being
right.
contained in, and then
and so I don't
the outside
know if that's possible. Not everything can be in equilibrium, so that's I'd have to check into that.
Because doesn't that create heat energy?
But then what's happening here is that it's using the heat energy to go backwards. Right, okay.
T story.
Okay, so you guys, what happens here is we can do three different things to mess with the equilibrium, and there is this thing called Le Chatelier's principle. I'm not gonna overwhelm you with that today. We'll talk about that tomorrow. We're gonna talk about basically what it is today, but I'm gonna try and make that as easy as possible for you, okay? So the first thing that we can mess with, and this is learning target 7, and I think it says something like, describe how concentration affects equilibrium, or something like that. And so you guys, the first thing I could do is I could change the concentration of one of these substances. And so what does that mean? That means I'm gonna change how much of something that we have. And so you guys, I have this scale up here, and notice that right now, it's balanced, okay? This is my reaction at equilibrium, okay? It's a balanced scale. And pretty much when something is at equilibrium, that scale wants to stay balanced. And so I want it to be equal. I can have this fulcrum here in the middle, okay? That's that pivot point, but I want it to stay equal. And so if I mess with one side, it needs to do something to fix itself so that it's equal again, okay? So what I can do is I could say something like, all right, you know what? I want to increase the amount of NH3. So you guys, if I increase the amount of NH3, what's this reaction gonna do? Which way is it going to shift in order to fix it? Okay, that's what you need to understand is which way will this reaction move in order to fix this, okay? So you guys, if I tell you I'm gonna increase NH3, the first thing you need to decide is, okay, which side is the NH3 on? The right side or the left side? The right side, correct? And so you guys, up here, which side is that? It's this one, correct? So if I tell you that I'm increasing it, does that mean that I'm putting some in or taking some out?
Putting some in.
You guys, what's gonna happen if I put something into this side of the scale?
It's gonna weigh down.
It's gonna go down. So let's put something in, let's increase that amount. And so we see that that side of the scale goes down. So then you say, okay, well, what side popped up? Which way do I need to go to fix it?
Plus.
To the left. And so you guys would say this reaction is gonna shift to the left. Well, what does that mean? Basically, it means I put more of this in, I gotta try and use it up. So what it's gonna do is it's gonna break all of that apart to get back to being equal. Dylan.
How do you know that it's like starts on the right side or doesn't matter?
Well, what I have to look at, I told you what I was putting more of in, and so I have to say, okay, where is that? Well, that's on this side. So if I put more on this side of the scale, oh, look, it's going to want to go to the left to get that scale even again. So you're just looking for where that substance is. Okay? So now, guys, let's look at another one. What if I tell you that I'm going to decrease the amount of hydrogen? Okay, I'm going to decrease the amount of hydrogen. And so in looking at this, guys, again, I have got my scale. Which side is the hydrogen on? The left side. And so if I take the hydrogen out, what happens?
It goes down or up.
It gets lighter, right? So if I take hydrogen out of this side went up, didn't it? Okay. And so now you look at this and you say, which side popped up? Which way do I need to go to fix it?
Left.
To the left again, because that left side was popped up. So again, I'm going to go to the left to fix it. Okay? All right. Next. Okay, the next thing I can fix, guys, or the next thing I can change, sorry. You guys, learning target 8 says, if I change the temperature, that will affect equilibrium. Well, here's the thing. In this reversible reaction, in this reaction at equilibrium, where's temperature?
On the right.
Yes. Why? Because it says what? What do you see that tells you it's there?
Heat
energy, exactly. You guys, heat energy, that represents our temperature. Okay? So you guys, if I tell you that I'm gonna change the temperature, again, I need to know which way this is gonna shift to fix it. So first off, guys, if I tell you that I'm gonna decrease the temperature, if I decrease the temperature, which way is this gonna go to fix it? And so even though temperature technically isn't matter, I'm gonna treat it like it is in this case because it'll make our lives a little bit easier. So go ahead and look at your scale. And we just found out that it's on the right, correct? So you guys, if I decrease the temperature, what do I need to do?
Take it off.
Take it off. So if I take that out, what does that do to that side? It goes up. Which means I need to go which way to fix it?
Right.
To the right, because that's the side that popped up, so that's the side that I need to fix. And what if I told you that I was going to increase the temperature of this reaction? And don't just tell me that it's the opposite, just because. You guys, if I increase the temperature, which side is the temperature on?
The right.
The right. So I want to put more in. And when I put more temperature in, what happens to this right side?
It
goes down, which means which way do I need to go to fix it?
Left.
To the left. Because if I put more in, what it's going to try and do is use it up. So so it will go back the other way so that it can use all of that extra heat. Okay. One more thing I can change. One more thing I can change. And that is number 9. And for that, I can change the pressure. You guys, for the pressure, all that matters for pressure is how much gas is in the reaction. Okay? I like to think of the pressure as when I'm increasing the pressure, I'm pressing down on a balloon. And when I'm decreasing the pressure, I'm letting go. Is it going still?
Yeah.
Okay. So you guys, if I increase the pressure, that means I'm pressing down on a balloon. Do I want to put more gas into my balloon in that case, or do I want to let some out? Do I want my balloon to pop? No. Okay, so if I increase the pressure, I probably want less gas, right? Because I don't want that balloon to pop. Okay, but if I decrease the pressure, do I want my balloon to have more gas in it or less gas? Do I want a floppy balloon or a blown up balloon?
Blown.
I want a blown up balloon, right? So if I decrease the pressure, I want more gas because I don't want that floppy balloon. And so then what you have to do is look at this reaction and decide how much gas do I have on each side. Okay, and how I'm going to do that is I'm going to look at these coefficients. Notice that in this particular equation I have gas, gas, gas. But sometimes you might see an S. What if this was an S? What would that represent?
Solid.
Solid. And if it was an L?
Liquid.
Liquid. And so you have to pay close attention to see which ones are gases. So you guys, there's no coefficient in front of the N, but what would that be?
One.
One. So I've got one there, plus how many gases do I have here?
Three.
Three. So you guys, how many total gases do I have on the left-hand side?
Four.
I have four gases there. And then on the right-hand side, how many gases is it producing?
Two.
Two. And so obviously, guys, the left side has more gas and the right side has less gas. Okay? Daphne.
What if it's just solids?
Then it wouldn't affect it. Okay. Then pressure wouldn't affect it. Okay? It only affects it when you've got gas. Okay? All right. So you guys, what if I tell you that I am going to increase the pressure on this reaction? Which way is this reaction going to shift if I increase the pressure? That means I'm pushing down on the balloon. To the right or to the left? Which side? How
right.
The right side. You guys are correct. Why?
Because it wants to balance out.
Because what's on the right side?
Less gas.
Less gas. Okay, and then obviously, you guys, if I decrease the pressure, I don't want the floppy balloon. So which way is it going to shift? Which way?
Left.
Left. Because the left side has more gas.